Hey, Don back again. Okay, so I got me some cardboard. Actually had a box that's had ordered something that I had already spread out. I actually have several. I've saved some really good ones, but this one I thought I was gonna throw it away because it's not a very good one. I thought, well, it's good enough for one time and getting grease on, so gotta make sure. I had to make sure to turn the staples all down. It was full of staples. That was why I stole it away, mostly because it was full of staples and I didn't want to get cut on it. Okay, where's my spot now? You can certainly move around a lot better. Oh yeah, I forgot something important here, which I would probably have to do. Oh no, no, it's gonna spin. I was thinking I had to put the transport case into neutral to get it to spin, but it'll spin with the transmission in neutral. I still need a pillow. This one here is not greasable. Okay. I don't think I have those big super strength ones in here. Like none of it's greasable. These are the non-greasable type here. Unless the grease starts in the center, I need a light. Yeah, it could have a standard grease cert in it. I kind of like to always use the greasable ones. So, it might have it. Dang it. My rag has been in the dirt and it's just throwing dirt all over my clean cardboard. Rid of this rag, go get another one. I gotta get up anyway. The whole point of this is to not wallow in the dirt and the cardboard is to not wallow in the dirt and the grease. That's one thing about working on cardboard I don't like. So let me go get another rag and light. To get a flash, I have two flashlights in my truck, a regular one and that rechargeable solar one. I was gonna get both of them, and I thought, well, get your drop light, it's right there, it's brighter than you. Okay, where is it? Where's my spot? And then I ran into the camera. There we go. Okay, now this one, you always, if I do have a greasable certs in there, they're very hard to get to because it's a CV joint basically. It's got two of them right there. Let's thinking, yeah, the only way you can really get to any of these to grease them is to have those kind like I have on the back, so I'm surprised. If I remember, because I didn't have much money and I didn't want, you know, those super strength ones cost about double of the standard ones. And this was not, since that front left axle bearing has been bad, I hardly ever used the front shaft. Used it one winter for an hour or so. And it really started making noise about the time we was about ready to head home. It was a good thing. I don't think I've used it since then. I used it to drive around in the snow just for the fun of it, ice and snow. We don't get that often. Took my neighbors around looking at it, taking pictures. So, I do not see. I got to put this up in the... Let me get to where... Oh, I can see both of them from here, but I don't see any. Is there more? Let me get around there and see if there's more. I can't remember. Yeah, there's another set back here. Okay. Yeah, they're the non-greasable type, and I don't believe there's a grease cert up in the U either, in the U of the U joint. So these can't be greased. The front one I do on the front one on this one can be, I saw it. Standard kind. Okay, let me get the camera moved and I'll show it. Drop it down or something. Let's see. Yeah, go ahead and drop it down because I think it won't fit up over there good unless I do. I think I slide it that way. I'll look at these back ones one more time before I give up because I remember that it's easy to miss it when you're looking. Sliding around on this slick cardboard is 10 times better than fighting. There in the center. The problem is the light. Let's see. Got it down low. Maybe I can do it there. Oh, if I can see to aim it. Yeah, that's easy for me to get to if I can aim at it that way. Now that's where I can turn it to so that it can be. Oh! Hit my head. Clean and grease. Gotta clean it off first. And this time, I won't be able to. Well, actually, you can do it. You can grease those round ones with that pointy deal. But it's a little tricky to keep it on there to do it. Oh, there it is. Yeah, no, not. Yeah, there it is right there. Standard kind. It'd probably be best just to do it normal. Get some of this off of here. You know, a lot of people will war. I used to when I was young. Everybody in the 70s, everybody wanted their engines clean and even the underneath of their car. You know, you want it to be a hot rod, but you wanted it clean and pretty to look at too. And I used to, I ran a car wash, 75 to 76, 70, yeah. And we used to clean our engines all the time. Well, there's not always, it's not necessarily a good idea for to keep them going, because I run into the bushings in my alternator once. I didn't worry about getting my distributor wet, because I would just, I had already learned to spray WD-40 in them to get them going again. And that worked fine. I'm getting the grease on my in the house extension cord. Not what I want to do. Okay, so. And of course I got grease right here where I'm gonna lay somehow. And not to mention all that dirt that just fell is full of grease. I know I'm whiny. I'm not a real mechanic. And I put on bug spray because the ants were over this area a while ago. Well, I guess the camera was off then. I mean, of course you wouldn't see it. Might have been waiting on me if I didn't turn it off. I don't remember. I don't think you were. Of course, you're not going to wait. You'll have to skip ahead when I go off to do things, unless I end up editing these. So, yeah, you can usually just poke the little ball bearing there and squeeze you some in that way. Sometimes I've had to do that because I couldn't get the deal on there when they're in, like in up there in the other end, the back end of this one. It's pretty hard to do, so I'm not going to try to do it. But I've done that before with those. This one I can get it on. Coming out of this side. I'll make sure it comes out of both sides before I quit. There. This time I won't have to overdo it because I can actually see what I'm doing. I know I overdid it on the other ones. So that one's done. This kind of thing, so much easier when you have a rack or a pit to, you know, you can do it standing up. That one's done. It seems, I can't tell there's any wear in it. I said it hadn't been used hardly at all anyway. But I'm going to be too filthy to want to go to the inspection space, I think. I wanted to just go after I do this, go, you know. We'll test drive it. I might be too filthy to test drive it, but I thought, well, if I go get cleaned up, I'm not going to go get cleaned up. I'll spray, try to make sure I get all the grease off my clothes and or put a towel in the seat and go, because I got to, you know, I'm going to wear my work clothes during my test drive. What if I have to do more work? So, even if, you know, you never know when something could go wrong on your test drive. I'm not going far. But if something went wrong and I had to get out there and mess with it, you know, definitely don't want to be all clean, fresh showered, and because I'm sticky and hot. It was about 77 when I came out, but I'm sure it's 80 to 85 by now. I came out around 7 o'clock today, because it's going to be 95 or 98 today. I think it's 95. I think. Maybe 93. I can't remember. Yeah, I mean, they change it every day. Well, I just unplugged my power. Sometimes that makes my camera quit, but it didn't work. I like making videos, but it can get you pretty aggravated when things start giving you trouble. Let's see. I kind of try to remember where I had it a while ago. If I put it too close, then I can't. Let's try putting it there and getting it aimed up. Maybe it will. There. I think the sun was probably ruining the shot completely. Well, the sun's moving, so. A while ago, I thought I had it okay. Now, I can tell you be able to see when I roll it, but there's one here and then another one up there. That's like a kind of like a CV joint on the front end of some of these little foreign cars and stuff. Or all these. There's no such thing as an American car anymore either, I don't think. Maybe some of the, maybe, I mean, you know, some of the parts are still made in America, but the, most of it, or half of it, three quarters of it, probably at least, is made overseas. The bodies and stuff. I think the motors for Fords might still be made in America. And, of course, it doesn't, it negates it in my mind. Like, it's good that, you know, you have the jobs and stuff, but like when GM Chevrolet, you know, got sold to a foreign country a few years ago, well, all the profit goes to another country now. So that negates the whole point of, you know, trying to buy American and save American jobs. I mean, maybe that, they already had factories overseas anyway to make GMs and stuff. Well, I think all cars do. But people used to say, back, I remember back in the 80s, there, you know, where we worked, Buy American was a big deal. I worked in the air fighter jet building factory. And that was a big deal to Buy American. That's when I especially started realizing that if we didn't, we were going to end up not having a job. And lots of people were buying Toyota trucks and stuff, and that's when they got popular. And one guy was telling me, oh, well, there's a factory over in the south somewhere, and they make a bunch of them. And I said, I mean, people, I said, well, number one, where's the profit go? Back to Toyotaville. And number two, how many jobs? You know, like, I think it was 500 or something. Maybe, let's say it was 2,500. That's a freaking piss in the pan. That's like a bad tip at the restaurant, you know? It's like a waiter getting a crummy tip compared to how much money and salary is, you know, spent on building cars. So, or anything, if any volume. So, I do not see anything. My light helps and hurts, blinds me. Okay, now maybe I can see. I don't know what happened to my view. Did I ruin it with the drop light? May have. Maybe it's all right. It's probably just a screen. I can get around a lot better with the car, sliding around on this cardboard than I could. On that creeper. I just got to where, on this side, I couldn't even do it. It was really hard over there. It just doesn't roll good anymore. I put two new wheels on it, but I didn't put all four years and years ago. And didn't, the ones that they had plastic wheels, I put some metal ones on one end and they roll pretty good. I don't know, of course, if you've got dirt and it hinders them or bumps or rocks, but I did sweep all the dirt I could and the sticks and rocks out from under here before I started. I'm gonna go around to the other side. Now my glasses are fogging up for some reason. I'm gonna go around to the other side of it and see if I can see any better. Yeah, all these little chunks of grease. Well, I was talking about cleaning your engines and all. Everything you wash, you get rid of. You get rid of the dirt, but you also get rid of the grease that keeps things from wearing out. So, really, if you clean too much, you better go back and grease it every time, or else you're really gonna break, make parts wear out prematurely. And steam cleaning was a big deal back then, and that was really good. And they would tell you, you know, you better grease your car if you're gonna get it steam cleaned. Because I wanted to get mine done. I had a 70 SS Chevelle, and I wanted it looking good, you know, every inch of it. And grease there. Oh, I can't hold my neck up to look when I lay down. If I'm sitting up, it's okay. This thing has had a chrome transmission pan, chrome oil pan, chrome valve covers. they're all rusty. Actually, the oil pans have been painted. I had the transmission rebuilt a few years ago, and it's it was rusty, and so the guy just painted it. I need a pillow. I actually have one. It's an old couch pillow. I'm gonna go get it because I just flat can't hold my neck up anymore. Be back. Sucks being old. Okay, I'm actually back. It was too dirty to not blow it off. Okay, let's see. And I was needing a little air bath anyway. Okay, let's get it this way. I'm gonna fold it in half. Maybe that'll be enough. Get too close, so I won't be able to see. I'm actually farsighted. But I need these magnifying glasses to see anything anymore. I did mention that before, but I really do like these. They're full, not just little spectacles, little, what do you call it? I bought a pair of safety glasses that were, they had a little spot on them, bifocal-like style magnifying, and they drove me nuts and made me dizzy. Eyes crazy. I couldn't use them. And then I broke the side. They were supposed to be real flexible and you could adjust them. I tried to adjust them because they were squeezing my head and they broke. And those were some name brand like DeWalt. And then I got these and I can't remember the brand. They're good. Made stronger. And the full thing is magnified. The only thing is I usually wear 125s on the computer so I can't see the computer with them. But they actually seem to be better for like actual real world looking at stuff. With the 1.5 for me. Yeah, there's no, really have to look close. There's no grease soaks in that one. Yeah, I think I just went ahead and set. I never had one of these brakes up here in this CV joint, so I think I decided I didn't need. Can't see it from there. While I'm here, let's take a look at my. Well, there's my transmission and everything. Got a little bit of dripping going on. That keeps, like I said, keeps everything from rusting. Not a lot. And when I first got this thing, I didn't care for the mufflers that much. The sound, I wanted them louder. I don't now, but I did back then. And, but they never wore out, so I never had an excuse to get any more. They're still not wore out. And if you get, I used to like glass packs. If you get those things, you probably get 3 years out of them, maybe. I don't know. You can get more, I guess, sometimes. And don't run water up in them to make them louder. That will blow out the glass and make them louder, but it will also get you a ticket. Because that gets seriously loud. Basically, you're running straight pipes. Oh, now my hat came off again. I don't guess it matters without the creeper. It's really the main reason I use the hat. Only thing is, my where I'm sitting down, my pillow's not happy with me. Oh, there we go. Trying to get around here to where I can see this front one. Okay, or the front side of this one, or whatever. I used to have some greasable ones in here. That's why I keep looking and looking. I see something that might be a greaser on those other kind. But it's not on the, see, they're usually on the, one of those little ones that you used to noodle on in here is what I'm thinking. I think I see one here. Getting to it would be another thing. No. Get in a position where I can actually hold my head up to look in there. Hang on, my rag is in the wrong place. It can't be seen by the camera, but I really don't know how I could put it that camera would. I could show it. I don't know how I would ever have gotten to it either. I can just see it, I think. It just doesn't look quite right. I think it's just that I can't see it. I'm pretty sure it's a grease. One of those ones that you need the needle for. Up in the dew joint part, I would have put that in there myself. That wouldn't have came that way. Probably so that I could grease it. Or he couldn't get to it to grease it. Yeah, it is one, I think. Got the rag on the end of my screwdriver. Yeah, that's one. Is there any way I can hit it with that thing? I don't see how I can do that. I guess I'll try and just see what happens. I think it's just going to squirt out the side of the... I'll move the camera to see. It might even help me see it. Sometimes it does. I may have moved it out of its spot anyway. I think my problem now is the light's hanging in the way, isn't it? Looks like it. It's up in here. That's too dark. Well, I'm just guessing then, because when I turn the light on, I can't see that little screen at all. So. I don't know. And I do that. Now that's the area of what you can see there. I don't know. I can just see that. I'm gonna see. I'll just leave it like that. That's the general area where I'm going. And try up there. I'll try to reason on it. I just figured out a spot to lay my. Put my head up against my tire. That's how I used to do it, I bet. Smooth as pillow. I don't want to grease it. Yeah, not to where I can see it. Now let's try. If I can get it to. I think it's just coming out. I can't see. I gotta be able to see if the grease is going in or just coming back out. I think it might be going in. I banged into my camera. I think I'm actually putting some in there. This thing's kind of will bend a little bit. It's flexible, so it makes me, because it's a quick connect that will flex a little bit. Okay, I think maybe let's just look around it and see. And spin it around and see if we got anything in it now. If anything's coming out of any of these other joints in it, I don't see anything. Ah, is that where I was doing it? Yeah. So it may have all just came back. I went all over the place. I don't think none of it went in there. You can kind of tell by how much resistance you have if you're getting some in there. Sometimes. That's why I thought maybe I was getting some in there. Because I couldn't see. Well, I sort of want to say it's not that important, but then that would be the ones that broke on me the first time I used them. Then I would say, why didn't I do that? Well, I was dirty and under the truck already. bet you there's one in that other one too. Grease circuit that I just haven't seen yet. I'm gonna try one more hit. At it. That's the only spot where I could possibly get to it, because anywhere else it would be. There's a the transfer case and the transmission. Well, that's the transmission. It's over there, so. Wouldn't let me do it from anywhere else. No, just going off and out. It's not going in there at all. So I can figure out a better way. There's no point in squirting grease all over, brand new grease everywhere, and not doing anything with it. Yeah, see this cross member that holds the transmission and transfer case up is in the way for any spot in the transmission on the other side, so turning it won't help. Well, since this has not been used and not being used, and I've never had them wear out on me, I may have to concede that I can't get to that one. Seems like I have, since it's there, it makes me think that I have succeeded before, since it's not the standard one. Maybe I tried and it didn't work. Am I getting it? I don't think so. When you start feeling pressure and it's hard to do, that usually means it's going. That was going in there, that might have been enough. My beautiful little hat's coming off again. Okay. Let's see. No, it's all everywhere. Okay, quit wasting grease. This rag is about ready to be towed away. I'm gonna look around that other one and see if I'm missing the cert on it, the one on the back. When you leave grease on there, it'll sling all over everything, but it doesn't really matter. Okay. But I got to get the bulk of it off this skull the next time I get in there. I don't get it all over me. Like right now when I scoot around here. So, let's move again. I'm getting ready for lunch. I woke up at about 10 till 4, so that's the reason I got out early today. Where is it? Yeah. That's too close, probably. Yeah. That's actually not bad. Okay, now. I had it further away before, probably couldn't see anything. Maybe you can this time. It's right here. I don't know when I move the light so that I can see. I don't know what's going to happen to the view, but we'll try it and see. Yeah, I've kind of given up on staying out of the grease. You always do after a while. Oh! Still have my pillow. I had to have that. Let's see, where do I want to be? I don't know. This maybe this gotta be able to look through the crack in there, though. You gotta have it in some spot where it opens up to where you could get the thing in there. And that's closed on that side. I think this whole one is closed no matter where you turn it. I think maybe I put my camera where I need to be. See it opening up, period. Yeah, if I had the kind that are on the end, like I have on the back, then I could grease them all easy. So, and like I said, I think I just went cheap because I used to do that. So I need to do those again. If these wear out, I will put the super strength with the greasers on the end. They save you a bunch of pain in the ass. This could be one that's not even greasable, but I know that other one is. I found the greaser. I mean, it's all turning perfectly well. It's not shaking, and like I said, you can't really tell most of the time, but and right now, it's especially the old case, since I can't even use it. But I want it to be to where to work. Let's look at the transfer case. I'm gonna do a free glance, free-handed here. That's the back end of it. Back end of the transmission. The other drive shafts. Turned around because it got tangled in. I guess this was a bad idea. Okay, so transfer case, big cast iron transfer case. I don't know, remember the model number. There's really just two that they put in these old trucks. And I used to know what mine was, but anyway, there's the run out of cord again. Headers, motor. I don't have a rock guard on my. I never have. I always thought I need to get one. I've actually never had any trouble. Never had any rocks get in my starter. And it makes the transmission run cooler. And this transmission is the one thing that has worn out on this truck. It's worn out three times now, I think, since 92. It's a turbo 350. And so I lift it off to keep it cool. Doesn't have a cooler for it or anything. But it's really, I think, I've had double 400s. And they're much, much tougher. And I think that's what they should have put in this truck. Just because it's a, well, of course, it wouldn't fit the small block, though. They fit the big blocks, so. That's, I think you can see what fits. Maybe it'll bolt up. You know, I can't even remember. I think it's bigger. I think the actual bolt. Let's just say the bolt pattern is bigger just because I can't think to say it right. But where's my hat? Oh, it's over there. So, that's my reason of my U-joints. It used to be a pain in the butt, but today, since I'm old and tired, it's killed me. So I'm gonna go eat lunch, and then maybe I'll get a little recuperated to where I'm gonna feel like going on my test drive and everything. I might have to get out of these clothes to go sit down to eat. You know? At least change this shirt. Put a towel on my chair or something, maybe. But okay. It's done, and I'll come back with whatever I do next. Probably will maybe take one of these cameras out. I'll have to take one that's fully charged on my test drive, and because I don't have a you know, a phone, an in-car phone adapter for these phones, so. Charger. All I need is a little USB adapter, and I can plug the regular one in there, but I don't even have that. So, it's gone. And we'll be back later.